Let's talk about how to wind a toroid. They're used in things like the Joule thief, like this one is. They're used in other electronic things. There's a couple basic ways of winding them, and it can be confusing, but it's quite simple once it's explained, so let's go over that. These are ferrite toroid cores, and they're often used in things like Joule thieves, and they are made for, they can be used for transformers, they can be used for coils, and so on. And today, I am going to show how to wind one of these. A lot of times they assume you already know how to wind them, but there's two basic ways to wind them. I'll show you how to wind them. So to make things clear, I'll use this large wooden ring. This will be our toroid. And we'll start out with our two colors of wire, in this case pink and brown, and I'm going to twist the ends together, which I've stapled them together so you can see that. And the first way is to run both wires in the same direction, either counterclockwise or clockwise. And when I talk about counterclockwise and clockwise, I'm always talking about looking one direction. If you first look left and then look right, it changes. So you always have to pick one direction and look and consider both sets of windings when you do that. So I always look to the left. So let's start out. We take both of our wires. They're tied together and we loop them like this around. And both wires are running the same direction. If you look, they're running this direction, and that of course is clockwise. So in this case, both of them are running clockwise. We could run them counterclockwise or anticlockwise by just going this way. And now both of them would be running the same direction, but now they're both running counterclockwise. Does it make a difference? No, not usually. So that's the first way of winding them, so that both windings are running the same direction. Either both are running counterclockwise or both are running clockwise. If your application calls for windings going in opposite directions, so that one set of windings is going counterclockwise and the other is going clockwise, it's easiest once again to start with your two wires twisted together on the ends and loop one through the center and one on the outside like I have here. And then what we'll do is we'll just start winding one. Just keep it going in the same direction it was, like this. And wind the number of turns you need, whatever that will be, like this. So if we look at this one, we'll see that this one is turning this direction. Again, we always want to look the same direction. We're looking left, so it's going this direction, which is clockwise. And then we'll do the other one, and we're just going the natural direction it wants to go, like this. And make the number of turns you need to make. And this one is going this direction, which is counterclockwise or anticlockwise. And again, make the number of turns you need. And that's it. Those are the two basic ways of winding a toroid coil. I've made two pretty much identical Joule thieves, same number of windings on primary and secondary. This one, they're both going in parallel, and this one they're going counter to each other in opposite directions, and so we can see which technique works the best. Well, here they both are. They're connected to the same battery, pointing at the table. And to me, it appears the top one is a little bit brighter. It doesn't matter when I change the angle a little bit, but the top one typically comes out ahead. And so, which one is that? Well, to answer your question, that is the one where the coils wrap in the same direction. Both wires are wrapped in the same direction, and this is the one where they're wrapped opposite. So, one's going counterclockwise, the other's going clockwise. So same direction, opposite directions. And so that kind of answers that question. It looks like when they're wrapped in the same direction, it works a little better. Well, I hope that's informative in your Joule thief experiments.